Hello, this is Erich Hunter, and I want to talk a little bit about Reiki with Pendulums. It's my new course, but I just wanted to talk about the subject a little bit. So many people who do Reiki, or if you are a practitioner of Reiki, you may have used a pendulum during the Reiki healing session. So many times people take like a crystal pendulum or something like that, or a wooden pendulum, and then they might douse the chakras to see which way they're spinning. Or you might use it like sort of in a manner like that, some basic dowsing. So the idea of having a pendulum like during a Reiki session is not completely like far out. It's not totally out there. Okay, so what my course though is about, it's not about dowsing at all. So like I had somebody say, oh, I've been doing Reiki with pendulums for 20 years, but they were talking about dowsing. It's not that. So what my course talks about are two different things. One is how can you do pendulum healing? So for those of you who aren't pendulum healers, most of you probably are, but just in case you aren't, pendulum healing is where you use the pendulum as an energy healing tool to send energy. And it's basically electromagnetic energy combined with energy from words, your spoken commands, and the properties of the pendulum spinning. So this is energetic healing. So using the pendulum as an energetic healing tool instead of using it as a dowsing tool. And dowsing means to ask questions or check things, to find hidden things. So in the course, I teach you how to use the pendulum as an energy healing tool during a Reiki session. And there's a very simple way to do that. If you have a healing pendulum, you can use it to very quickly heal the aura, heal the chakras, and do a lot of work on the person before you even start doing Reiki. So you can very quickly, like in about 5 minutes or less, using a special healing pendulum, you can go over a person and you can very quickly get their energetic body healed to a large extent. And then that way, when you start doing your Reiki, there's less resistance to their Reiki energy flowing through the person. Okay, another thing you can do with the pendulum is you can prepare a person for a Reiki session. So with pendulum healing, I have like an emotional healing protocol that allows you to heal any blocks they have with emotions before the session. And I have other healing protocols that you could use. So that's one thing. You can bring the pendulum to a Reiki healing. Then the other aspect of this is you can bring the Reiki to a pendulum healing. So let's say you know Reiki and you know how to do pendulum healing. Well, there's absolutely no reason why you can't do them both simultaneously. So in the course, I explain how you would go about doing that. But basically, you know, Reiki energy flows when you ask it to flow. So you can have a flow during a pendulum healing. Why not? Okay. Now, why would you want to do this? Why would you want to combine Reiki with pendulums? Because there are Reiki purists out there, and I know I'm not going to convince any of them. There are Reiki purists out there who say, oh, Reiki energy is enough by itself to do everything. But that's not exactly true. There are different types of energy. Reiki is considered to be like ki or prana or chi. It's sort of like a form of conscious life force energy that Reiki masters can channel due to their connection to a lineage that connects it back to the source based on a mystical experience had by the founder of Reiki. All right, so that's one kind of energy, this ki or prana or chi. But pendulum healing does not use that kind of energy really at all. So if you do a pendulum healing and you combine it with Reiki, you get the benefit of having the Reiki energy, but also the energy from the pendulum. And then the cool thing about Reiki and pendulums together is that neither Reiki nor pendulum healing depends on the healer's energy. Now, of course, the healer is going to expend a little bit of energy. When you're doing Reiki and you're holding your hands in a certain position, that requires energy because, you know, you're doing work, you're holding your hands up in the air. Just like with a pendulum healer, if you take your pendulum and you let your pendulum spin around, yeah, it requires some of your energy to hold the pendulum or some of your energy to make a command. But you're not using your own energy to stimulate healing in the person. So the bulk of the energy coming is not from you just holding the pendulum or holding your hands for the Reiki. It's because of the energy that is either flowing through you in the source, in the case of the Reiki, or being emanated, you know, off from the pendulum. So with the pendulum, the idea there in the radionics of pendulums is that light, mostly electromagnetic energy from the environment, interacts with this pendulum. So it's a very passive process. There's a little bit of electromagnetic energy from your own body, like biophotons from your hand maybe coming out. And then also when you say words, that requires energy, and those have an impression on the person. So there is energy involved, but it's mostly not your own energy. And the bulk of the energy is coming from the environment. So combining Reiki and pendulums is a really smart idea because you get the benefit of the Reiki healing with the benefit of the pendulum healing. So you get a more, a wider range of quote unquote energies available to stimulate healing. Because when a healer is doing their work, you're not actually healing anybody. What you're doing is you are trying to stimulate someone else to respond to the signals that you're giving them. And if their body, mind, spirit, whatever, can respond, they can initiate a healing process themselves. So you are a healer in the sense that you are going through the actions to stimulate healing, but ultimately it's the person themselves who either can or can't heal. So you're trying to increase the probability that healing will occur. So the more that you bring to the situation, different types of healing, different types of quote-unquote energy. In the case of pendulums, it is considered electromagnetic energy, which is scientific energy. Obviously, ki or prana is not considered scientific energy. But it's still called energy. You are getting more of a chance, you're increasing the probability that you will stimulate a healing response in the person that you're trying to help. So it's really cool. It's super easy to combine these two healing methods. In the course, I explain how to do it both ways, how to bring a pendulum to a Reiki session and how to bring Reiki to pendulum sessions. And I explain it for all three levels of Reiki, including the Reiki Master. And then I also talk about other issues related. I talk about how you can heal yourself, how you can actually do healing on your Reiki lineage. There are all kinds of really amazing things that you can do to enhance your Reiki healing and also enhance your pendulum healing. So you can enhance both. If you're a Reiki practitioner who's never done pendulum healing, there's enough information in the course to get you started, but then I also have two free courses that you can take that will give you a lot of information where you can pretty quickly start incorporating pendulum healing into your Reiki healing sessions. And just kind of a fun thing, I've developed a new pendulum here. This one is the Merkaba pendulum. I have two versions of it. This is the version without rings. Sorry if it's not completely focusing. It's a pretty amazing pendulum. This one here is pretty much ideal for doing Reiki with pendulum healing. This pendulum, oh, has a nice sound too when you hit it by accident. This pendulum is negative green, and it has the most wonderful energy I've ever felt on one of these types of pendulums. It's the spiritual energy, the spiritual carrier wave. It's perfect for doing this kind of work, and it stimulates a healing response in people. Really great. And it also taps into this power of the Merkaba or the Merkaba, the spiritual ascension force. So really good. Anyway, side note, but thank you for listening to this video. I hope you found it interesting. You can ask questions or comments below.